that I've sent an email to. And he's a very weird person. He's also a Lord, but he likes sometimes to go with my nickname, Lord T. So he's here tonight, as well as starring in the play, to give you some important information that you need to know before we start the play. And the play is run by Adam, who is a fantastic director and writer with amazing cast. So to start off, let's bring out my friend, who is called Lord T.
Smile floods your memory stronger than
strong.
Damn right as a block.
I'm Jeremiah, my friend. I've been looking for you. Not still rooting for the fair Aurora, are we?
Can words have a purer use?
Spoken like a true artist. Or do it, but I doubt there's much of a difference.
I'm sorry. I cannot banish it from my thoughts. I mean, my pen moves as my heart beats fast. Besides, isn't it true that you snuck a rather exposing letter under the door of Lord Presley's daughter nearly a week ago?
And where did such an accusation come from?
I have my sources.
Slow your excitement, my friend. Granted, I showed interest only at my usual level. But not as wholesomely romantic as you, my friend.
Ah, commitment to a single soul. You should try it.
A word of advice, my friend. A mind full of whimsical ideas is not
nor is one full of cynical and hollow ideals.
Conversations with you, my friend, are never boring. I'll give you that. Keep living in them a little more. Anyway, I've come to find out if I shall be scouting the town for companionship all on my lonesome at the town banquet tomorrow night.
I don't know. I'm so close to finishing this decoration to Aurora. It must be perfect.
Ah, you see, I had planned for such an answer. It may be of interest to you that tonight's benefactor is Lord Talus himself.
Aurora's father? Very well, your piques and interest. I will attend. I will see and talk to her.
A word of advice, my friend. She is a lady, and her father is a man of industry, and you are a rather unprosperous poet who is interested in being a teacher. I will say this to you. You're playing with fire, which is something you're not equipped to do. Well, that is my area of expertise.
A walk of her, a wisdom of generations. The blush on her cheek, sweeter than the richest fruits. Truly, I simply let my heart speak.
You have a way of words beyond many of the men I'm acquainted with in this town.
Well, I'd like to say we're more than simply acquainted.
Yes. I remember when you would yell to my balcony when we were still children.
Silly childhood nonsense.
Then, when was it? 2, maybe 3 years ago? The duo turned into a solo. Your words morphed from childish nonsense to heartfelt poetry.
And I meant every word. And may I say, you look radiant tonight.
I see William is hopping around.
I believe we went to speak to the Grey Sisters. Maybe it was the Greystone Brothers, actually. Wait, is that a nun? No, never mind.
Ah! There you are, Aurora! I hope I am not interrupting. After all, you are the daughter of a benefactor of this event. I see your affections, my daughter, have not ceased.
No, it has not.
You heard me. Aurora is due to be married to another in a matter of weeks, to a man more suitable for her. Therefore, I suggest you make peace with this news and move on. Enjoy the rest of your evening.
Married? How? Aurora told me nothing of a such. I mean, perhaps she must not want to, or perhaps her father's forcing her to do it. Whatever this must be, I must find out. I must speak to her. But to do it here would be fruitless. Later. Aurora!
Jeremiah, what are you doing here? I can't talk, I'm going to meet my father.
It's a discussion of upcoming marriage.
How did you?
Who do you think?
My father. I should have known. I had been meaning to tell you, I just could not find the heart.
Aurora, you don't have to go through this, just your father demands it. We can run away together. We can make a life together.
We can't, Jeremiah.
But we can be free of it.
Jeremiah,
but
please listen to me. I'm not being forced to marry.
But who?
Ah, Aurora, my dear, there you are. This is all.
You?
I see she has already broken the news.
Could this really be you? Who I foresaw as a brother, betraying me such?
Betray you? I don't think that we can call this a betrayal. More a triumph. What is it that they say? The best man won?
Nonsense! You knew I only wished for her happiness. You knew my intention for Aurora these past few years. Only a fool would believe a go behind my back would not lead to such hurt. I know you are many things, William. A fool being not one of them.
When are you going to stop with that annoying and droning chivalrous demeanor of yours? So many people have told you, myself and Lord Talis among them. I also said you were playing with fire. I said doing so was my own expertise, not yours.
I am warning you not to continue your words, William.
The world is changing. Your words are like dust. They simply blow away and are meaningless.
Will!
Actions have effect. Words are worthless, and that is why you're standing here like a bloody deaf bat. You and I even have a better old friend.
Actions. I'll show you actions, you bloody bastard!
Thank you. He's a local pub, and I live around here.
Still about those?
They said it would be bloody well done for Christmas. Some roach dogs.
You really believe that? I say a lot of things. It's always the same.
What do you mean, always?
No, just twat on my arse. Anyway, stop reading this all day and night. Just don't stress yourself.
Stress? I'll tell you who's really stressed. The lads all day fighting, bleeding and sweating and runs.
Oh, they always bleed and it's always sad. It's just war.
Just war? It's just a war. It's the great war, the most largest and the most war we ever had.
Oh, my history book, my friend. Regardless of the size of operation, they all function the same.
The cynic of you.
How else am I supposed to look here? I'm not exactly eager to aid the cycle of violence.
Yeah, better don't translate that to that comfy of the jurors. Make it an for you. Man.
Better than a bullet or one of the bloody medals. Anyway, why are you so obsessed with this repressing crap lately? You let that wrong to me, mate. I don't want to see you make an ill-fated decision. I'm looking out for your back from the crows, the real and metaphorical ones. This world is bloody wars. Now fail to outdo themselves.
Thank you. you at this time. By this point, I'd seen more than enough war in my life, but it wasn't the only thing that I feared. You see, I was close to changing again. I doubt I had maybe a year or two left, the way I was then. To change on the front lines would be to reveal that side of my nature, something I was foolishly not ready to do, not even to my friends.
Dennis, what is that commotion next door? I can barely hear myself think.
The open door recruitment office next door. You know what I'm like? Always busy.
Of course.
Of course. Our work is just as important.
The only reason that's true is because the English refuse to learn any other language.
You're not wrong yet, but I'm sure that'll change. Doesn't that fill you with a sense of pride to all those men going out to show the world we're not pushovers?
That's a cozy view, isn't it?
What do you mean?
It's like some Newtonian children before bed. I learned a long time ago that all that idealistic nonsense is just in your head. The real world, not the same.
Doesn't that give you comfort to hold on to something, though? We can't always think of the gloom, Jeremy.
Whatever you say, Daniels, whatever you say.
Anyone's saying that.
Why be so awful with it? Look, just stop for a minute and think. Be more cautious.
In a world with times always running, there comes the topic to be cautious. Sure, I can give another 50, 60, if I'm lucky. I was a coward, driven by fear of guilt, of course, who did what I couldn't. But I believe for a single day, being the person I want to be. I know which one I'd rather pick. Goodbye, from you.
Goodbye, hero.
Jump forward a few months, I think. My mind gets a bit murky with the exact times. I had, of course, continued my stubborn and self-righteous attitude, just waiting for a wake-up call. And boy, did I get one.
Mister, a letter for a Mason Street.
Ah, Casey, it's down speak from Ben. Probably sending me his exciting tales from the front. Thank you.
On the front lines, your friend.
Yeah, decided you wanted to be a hero.
Decided not to go yourself.
Is that all?
Yes, good day.
Anyway, Ben, what have you got yourself up to? Hold on, why is his mother sending me a telegram? So he's dead then? Well, I shouldn't be surprised, but yeah, I am.
Coward!
Coward? Is that what I am? Not logical or cautious? Just a coward? All throughout my life, my fear has held me back, controlled me. Not my fear of war and violence, but my fear of being my true self. But He was a hero. He was always there for me, regardless of what. He would have wanted us to walk side by side as brothers, but instead I slapped away his hand and allowed him to walk to his death alone. He was brave. He couldn't allow the war and violence to go on. He knew it was wrong, but instead of just standing to the side, brushing it off, he had to go. He was selfless. And now it's too late. Maybe if I'd gone, I could have made a difference. But now I'll never know. There is one thing I know though. I am a coward.
The resilience of a person, show them who they truly are in this world instead of who they like to think they are. Many pass this test in the end and don't let these feelings define their lives moving forward, while some never truly move forward and wallow in their own self-pity. Safe to say that I was never anything but the latter in this situation. Moving on from ghosts was never really a talent of mine.
Years of practice, my friend, years of practice.
Coward. 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 Coward.
Hey man, you enjoying the party?
Yeah, you know it. Have you seen that girl that's been around lately? The one that kept falling over. It's really funny. She's been every day in the past week except for today.
Come on.
say something. You're a dick. Thank you. Anyway, let me get this straight. You were partying with this guy called Perry. He was trading in substances that, shall we say, even Woodstock would have you arrested for. And then, in a state of panic, he spotted you, chased you down, killed you, and that should have been the end of it. End of it?
I was murdered.
But then, you decided to leave the letter in just this tent to easily link back to your fate. Which, I know. Of course, didn't work out because like 10 minutes later he came back and killed you.
I was trying to get help. She was the first person I thought of. At least if I didn't get away, she would know what happened.
I mean, you only put her in danger because, like, she doesn't have a girlfriend, but she's read the letter. And, well, on one hand, that means that she could be safe, and on the other hand, it could mean you kill her if she's read the letter, which will put her in a lot of danger. Could be worse, she could be fully sober.
I know.
See, recently? What? You're the one who turns into a nagging pain every time I try to take a swing.
Can you be serious for literally 5 minutes?
Now, if I did nothing to the skin.
For the last time you're serious?
Serious?
Definitely, that would. Serious as you care. It means all the money peeking through the cracks and keep them inside. Start to wake up. More shit you spend denying it exists will come to light.
Jesus. Who hurt you?
Other way around, actually. That is a development.
Ooh, excuse me.
That's not drink.
I'm busy.
Hey, maybe you should be careful if that's...
That's
not. That is poison.
Ooh. How are you not dying?
As I said, I'm something I'm going to do myself.
Anyway, what's it now?
She is in danger.
You're welcome. Bye.
Wait.
The people you see are.
Castle of stone, as cold and barren as its thoughts. A gripping field of great defense, a dark knight standing guard, ready to avenge a cold, like heart. The charred ground sighing the walls, brick by brick, forcing its evasive yet unstoppable mount. Somewhere only the faint of heart would go. A misty route down the yellow brick road, a frosted rose at the end of a trail. Time, hands, prime, and rain. any soul capable of touching its smoke-steeled doors would be the soul capable of melting the mightiest glaciers. And wouldn't that be a story to behold?
Excuse me, miss. It's Abigail, is it not?
Yeah.
Good. I wanted to get this over with.
Get what
over? No, just this.
What the hell?
Sorry, but your sister should have kept her mouth shut.
But my sister really would. She just died. What could she have done?
Yeah, I don't see the point in explaining this and wasting opportunity considering what's about to happen.
Oh, good. She's not dead yet.
All right.
Right.
Who are you?
Good Samaritan.
Thank you.
my opinion.
First is that of naivety and romanticism, which often comes with youth, which takes a form of heartbreak by the ones you love or simply the world around you for that view to crumble.
Secondly is one I feel to be most relatable to all of us, the bitter journey of fear, which pushes us to commit acts of suffering and cowardice, not to mention feeling the two most dangerous things in life, as well as the most painful, guilt and regret.
Our third journey is closely linked to our second. Joy and fun are a necessity in life to make it worth living, as is often the key to happiness. But at a certain stage in our lives, we'll feel a sense of hollow joy, use it to fuel and deny it. We spend our whole lives making mistakes, but we'll learn.